A Colt Python is loaded by first pulling the cylinder latch to the rear. This unlocks the cylinder by means of the spring-loaded latch pin. The crane is now able to swivel the cylinder out of the frame. Cartridges are then loaded into all six chambers. The cylinder is then pushed back into the frame and then rotated to ensure the bolt has locked it into position. Many revolvers feature both double action and single action operation. In double action operation, the trigger is pulled until it cocks and releases the hammer to fire. In single action operation, the hammer is drawn back to the cocked position and held by the sear. Squeezing the trigger releases the hammer to fire. As the trigger is pulled, the trigger pushes up on the hammer strut, cocking the hammer. As the hammer rotates, the main spring is compressed by means of the hammer stirrup and the rebound lever, which is pushed up by the trigger. As the hammer reaches its cocked position, it slips off the trigger. Simultaneously, the trigger pushes down on the bolt, dropping it out of the cylinder pocket. The hand engages the ratchet of the cylinder ejector, indexing it to the next chamber. Just as the hammer is released, the bolt drops into the next pocket, locking the cylinder's rotation. At the same time, the trigger raises the transfer bar up behind the firing pin. As the hammer is released, it strikes the transfer bar, transferring its energy to the firing pin, which travels forward, impacting the cartridge primer. This detonates the priming compound and ignites the powder charge, propelling the bullet down the barrel. With the rebound lever under constant tension from the mainspring, its tension is transferred to the trigger. Releasing the trigger pivots the hammer strut out of the way, allowing it to return to its forward position. During single action operation, the hammer is pulled back, driving movement of the trigger. At its peak, the trigger rests on the sear surface of the hammer. Pulling the trigger releases it from the hammer sear, allowing it to strike the transfer bar. Releasing the trigger again resets its forward position. To eject the empty shell cases, the cylinder latch is pulled, allowing the cylinder to swivel out of the frame. Holding the revolver in a vertical orientation and pushing the ejector rod forces the cases out of the cylinder.